friends. In this lecture, we are going to explore the main characteristic of Nodemcu. Yes, that is the Wi-Fi. So, using Wi-Fi, we are going to connect Nodemcu into the network, and using a remote browser, we will make an LED on and off. So friends, let's explore the remaining part, how we can do it. Friends, let's connect the Nodemcu with the laptop or desktop from where you are going to upload the code. After that, start the Arduino IDE. Remember, here we are supposed to work with the offline mode, as online mode don't allow us to work with the Nodemcu into the free account. Now, after connecting hardware and make necessary changes in the Arduino IDE, let us do the modification into the code. So, the very first part of the code is including the header files. Here we are including 4 header files which are either required for the client server communication or it is required for the wireless communication. Now, as most important thing is the Wi-Fi setting, as we are going to connect Nodemcu with the Wi-Fi which are available in our range, so we need to specify the name of the Wi-Fi. Here I have provided the name of the Wi-Fi as a virus and the password as a 0987654321. You must specify the wireless ID and the password of your network where you are supposed to connect. Next part of the code is where we are supposed to connect the LED pin. Here I have specified that LED pin is equal to 4. That is nothing but a GPIO number for the pin number D2 on Nodemcu. The next part is showing you where I have connected the LED in actual. As well as the last sentence of this code is Wi-Fi server, server 80. This indicates my Nodemcu to start a server on port number 80. As Nodemcu is having a feature of client server communication, this sentence is creating or allowing the server to operate on port number 80. Here it shows the actual pin connection of LED with the Nodemcu. Friend, make sure the positive leg of LED and negative leg of LED are connected at appropriate position only. Otherwise, you will not be able to see any difference or it may not give you any kind of proper output. Now, as we know, Arduino IDE having major two functions, that is the void setup and void loop. Now, whatever we are going to write, that is inside the void setup function. Remember, it is inside the void setup function and void setup will execute only once. Now here the first sentence called serial.begin into bracket 115200. This is nothing but a baud rate. We are supposed to specify baud rate for the serial communication between the devices. Next one is the delay, which is giving a 10 millisecond delay. After that, we are specifying that pin mode 4 number pin would be considered as an output pin. Now, the most important part of Wi-Fi here is wifi.begin into bracket SSID and the password. That is the step number 1. We need to make sure that it is going to initialize the Wi-Fi connection. Now, after that, whatever we have written in step 2, that is just an establishing the wireless connection. If it gets succeed, it will go ahead with the third part. Otherwise, it is not going into the third step of this program. Let's assume that the program has already established the connection with the Wi-Fi. After that, the third number says server.begin. It means we can start the server. And after that fourth one will give us the appropriate IP address of Nodemcu. Friends, as everyone knows, whenever the device is connected into the internet, it has one unique IP address. And here, when we say that we are connected with the Wi-Fi in our local range, then it is giving an IP address to that particular node. Now the question arises, where we can see the output of serial.print function. So friends, we are going to see that output into the serial monitor, and how to check that we'll explain at the end of this lecture. Next part of the coding is the loop function. That is nothing but the void loop function. Now here I have given the number 1, 2, 3. That is the three steps. Let's understand the first step. The first step is giving an instruction to your Nodemcu to make sure that the client-server communication is possible or enabled. So just type these commands and the sentences into your code. The second step says that what happens when someone is clicking on the on button. So that second step gives an instruction to your Nodemcu to make LED on. And the third is nothing but the making the LED off. I think there is no issue in the step 2 and 3 because it is in most common functions and the name which you have already seen in Arduino also. But the part 1 is quite difficult. But friends, right now don't go into the depth of each and every syntax or the sentence. Just type it and experience the program. Further, inside the void loop function itself, start typing the client.println. It is nothing but sending the instruction to the client at the time when client is requesting the Nodemcu. And here, when we are saying that we are making LED on and off using the browser, then the detail, whatever we are writing between the client.println, it is nothing but a normal HTML syntaxes. So whenever client is requesting to the Nodemcu, Nodemcu sends the HTML output to the browser and it will give you the actual HTML page. Now here the important point is, I have shown into the arrows where it is written LED equal to on and LED equal to off. Again, it is inside the particular client.println and it is into the AHREF, that is creating a link to the particular part. So if you remember the previous section where we have mentioned something called LED on and LED off, so it is with relation to that. If you have not mentioned the proper name or same name, then it may not work appropriately. So now I hope it is quite clear. Try to complete the whole program, check for the errors, remove the errors if anything, and upload into your browser and test it. This is the output of serial monitor. Now to get this window, just go to the tools menu. You can find the serial monitor option, click on that and this window will open, provided you are connected with the Nodemcu onto that laptop or desktop. Now when this will open, just make sure that the port number which is shown on the top of this is the same port where your Nodemcu is connected. Second thing, the baud rate at the bottom shows that the baud rate you have specified must be the same as you have specified at the initial part of the coding. And in between, somewhere you have specified that serial.print into bracket the IP address. So the IP address is shown in this window. No doubt, if the port number is not correct, if the baud rate is not correct, you are not going to see anything into this screen. As well as, if you are not connecting your hardware with your laptop or desktop, this serial monitor is not going to appear. So please do the necessary things, then only this serial monitor will come. Now open the browser from any of the computer or laptop which are connected into your Wi-Fi where the Nodemcu is also connected. Use this IP address and have a fun to make on and off the LED. As soon as you click on the on, the LED will glow. As soon as you click on the off, LED will be off. By default, LED will remain off. Friends, I believe you understand the Wi-Fi feature of Nodemcu and you have understood the whole program and the whole experiment. Now I believe using the Wi-Fi feature, you can create a lot of application. Once you know the IP address of your Nodemcu, it becomes a server for your network to switch on and off the LED which is connected with the particular Nodemcu.